Hello everybody, my name is Phaethodas, welcome to this Challenge Rift video. We have the Invoker build here. This is a Thorns build of a Crusader class. We can see the items here. This is a Thorns build. It is a very powerful build for this greater Rift level that it plays within. We can see the items here. Not the best versions of items, but it doesn't really matter because this build is very powerful. And the Rift is very good. There are plenty of elites, I could say. In the first floor there are about 2 or 3 packs only, but in the second and third floors there are many more elite packs and also some shrines, and you can play and complete this build. But you have to play and complete this Rift successfully. You have to play, of course, the right way. Now, if you are new to this class, or maybe this set of invokers and this gameplay style, or this game overall, this is what you want to be doing when you go in the Rift with this specific build. First of all, you use the Steed Charge because this one helps you run around faster, pass through enemies, so this is very helpful if you go to move faster through the Rift. You need to activate Iron Skill, skin. With this one your Thorns is increased, of course, and you get more toughness, you survive better, so this is very good. You activate it especially when you fight against Elite Packs, of course. Because it is when you need mostly the toughness and more damage output. Damage output comes from your Thorns. You activate Consecration sometimes when, again, against Elite Packs mostly, or many big masses of enemies when they come to get you, they surround you. Then you use this one. This helps with your survivability, and also it helps with dealing more Thorns damage. They take more Thorns damage when they come to the area of this skill, which is this one down here. This is the radius. It is good enough because this is a close combat build after all, so there is no problem. This is a very nice area. You have the provoke. You use this one. When you use this one to enemies, enemies that are affected by this one come to you, closer to you, they come to hit you. This is why it is called provoke. And this one increases chances also to block after casting provoke. This is very good because you got all of the enemies to come to be next to you. You don't want to chase them, one enemy here, one there, and you run to each one of the enemies. If there are some enemies close by, you hit this one, they come all very close to you, and you start hitting them with your main attack, which is the slash. This is the skill that you use to deal damage to your enemies. But before the skill, we have the Akarat Champion. This is a very nice skill, of course it has a long cooldown. You use this one, again, mostly against Elite Packs, because it provides much more survivability and also it increases your damage and your wrath regeneration, which is not a problem after all, you don't lose any wrath, so you use this one for toughness and damage. And now for the final skill, which is the slash. This is the skill you use to hit your enemies and kill them. With this one you have to be going mostly on Elite Packs. To be successful in this Rift, you need to hunt down elites, actually. When you see very close by Elite Packs, you ignore the small enemies, you go to blue or yellow elites, and you hit them with your slash attack. So, when you see an Elite Pack of a yellow and a white elites, you go and hit straight to the yellow. You hit straight the yellow because when you kill the yellow elite, then it drops down the spheres, the globes that give you time for the bar here in the greater rift. And this way you progress further, faster into the rift. And when you see, of course, blue elite packs, you hit all of the blue elites with your attack, which means you ignore white enemies when you see blue or yellow elite packs. You go straight for elite packs, you hunt down elite packs, and you will see in a minute how I did my run in the challenge rift. actually I was ignoring many small normal enemies, and I was trying to fight that hit elite packs, so I was very ahead of time, and it was a very easy and successful attempt for my greater rifting. So this is the attack you use to hit enemies, and especially hit elites. This you use this one to increase your damage output and also to gain more armor. You use it mostly against elite packs or other situations, tough situations where many enemies are in front of you. They do not allow you to pass them by. You use this one to provoke some enemies to make them come all closer to you, so you don't have to chase them away, to hunt them. You use consecration. Enemies that are inside the radius of the skill, they receive even more thorns damage, and also you gain life regen. You use this one to increase your thorns damage, but also to increase your toughness. And you use stitch charge to run faster. Of course, you should also take a look at the sets of the bonus, because these will tell you how you should play this build, when to use your skills, how to use them. It is a very easy and a very powerful build to play with. You just have to do the right things. Hit chase elite packs and hit them with the slash skill, especially when you have active the Akarat Champion and the Iron Skin. So this is it. It is simple as that. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. I will reply as soon as possible. Good luck with your challenge rifting. From here on, if you wish, you can keep watching this video. You will see how I did in my... It was not my first attempt, it was my third attempt in the rift. Because in the two first attempts, I was trying to see where elite packs are, and I was trying to memorize the locations of elite packs, because to be successful, you need to hunt down elite packs with this build. So, have fun!
Patience. Yeah. yet.
Great success.
Goodbye.